The next grammar point is possession with ka. The postposition ka expresses possession. It can be translated into English as apostrophe s to show the possession. For example, Ram's house, Ram ka ghar. The possession ka behaves like a variable adjective. That means it changes according to the number and gender of the thing possessed. As you can guess, ka is for masculine singular object, ke is for masculine plural object, and ki is for feminine singular and plural object. If you have noticed, you can see that the same ka appears in few possessives too. Aapka, your, uska, his, her, unka, their. Let's take some examples to elaborate the usage of postposition ka. Radha ka ghar, Radha's house. Ghar, house is masculine singular noun, that's why it is ka, Radha ka ghar. Radha ki kitab, Radha's book. Kitab, book is feminine, that's why it is ki, Radha ki kitab. Let's take another example. Rakesh ka ghar, Rakesh's house. Again, ghar is masculine, that's why it is ka. Rakesh ki kitab, Rakesh's book. Kitab is feminine, so it is ki. The choice of ka or ki is based on the thing possessed, regardless of who is possessing it, a boy or a girl. Radha ke kapde, Radha's clothes. Kapde is masculine plural, so the postposition ke is used. Radha ke kapde, Radha's clothes. Radha ki ghadiyan, Radha's watches. Ghadiyan is feminine plural, that's why it is ki. There's no difference between feminine singular and feminine plural. It is ki for both. Radha ki ghadiyan, Radha's watches. The same way, Rakesh ke kapde, Rakesh's clothes. Rakesh ki ghadiyan, Rakesh's watches. Kapde is masculine plural, so postposition ke, Rakesh ke kapde, Rakesh's clothes. And ghadiyan is feminine plural, that's why it is ki. Rakesh ki ghadiyan, Rakesh's watches. Let's take some example sentences. Radha ka kamra bada hai, Radha's room is big. Kamra is masculine singular, so it is ka, Radha ka kamra, Radha's room. The next one, Radha ke kamre bade hai, Radha's rooms are big. Here, kamre, rooms are masculine plural, so the postposition ke is used, Radha ke kamre, Radha's room. Radha ki kitab achhi hai, Radha's book is good. Kitab is feminine singular, so the postposition is ki, Radha ki kitab, Radha's book. And the final one, Radha ki kitabein achhi hain, Radha's books are good. Kitabein is feminine plural, so it is same as singular ki, Radha ki kitabein. Let's take a few more example sentences. As I mentioned that ka is the postposition, so the noun before it declines, it changes with the postposition. Bacche ka kamra hawadar hai, the child's room is airy. Bachcha becomes bacche because of the postposition. Bachchon ka kamra hawadar hai. The children's room is airy. It is plural, so that's why it is bachchon. Bachchon ka kamra, children's room. Ladki ka kamra hawadar hai. The girl's room is airy. And the final one, ladkiyon ka kamra hawadar hai. The girl's room is airy. The room of the girls is airy. Here, the girls is plural noun, that's why it is ladkiyon. Ladkiyon ka kamra, girl's room, room of the girls. In all these examples, the postposition ka is used because the thing possessed here is kamra, room, which is masculine singular.